Всем привет! Как дела? How are you doing? What we're going to do now is warm up a little bit, flamenco style. Flamenco style warm up. Not a very early morning, but still. I invite everyone to stretch a little bit and get some flamenco mood, get into some flamenco mood, okay? And I've prepared something for you, so just chatting a little bit while maybe somebody joins. So, what this thing is all about is the live sessions of a warm-up that I usually do for myself a lot. And when I come into the class, I just warm up, stretch, and improvise. And this is what helps me, you know, get going and get into the mood. And then maybe I practice some more difficult steps, and then I learn some choreography. So that's kind of my usual routine. And now, since you know, all this lockdown happened, since the time I'm doing these live sessions, to invite everybody to join me during these warm-ups and maybe get into the mood and maybe get the kick out of dancing and moving and trying some flamenco stuff, okay? So, one more notice to my guys. So maybe somebody would like to join. All right. So, anyway, cajon, place to rest. Anyway, I suggest start. Get stretching, nice and easy. Do whatever you feel like doing. I always, for this, I will start with your body. We start with the feeling, okay? How you would like, what you would like to do, what your body likes. Stretch out. Any of your comments, if you send some. A bit more. Okay. Touch with our hips. Until you get very warm, okay? Just keep going and going. The other leg. All right. Up. way around. Yesterday or the day before yesterday, like dancing, I mean, or maybe some exercise, then you probably should feel, you know, your muscles sore, but also it feels like you have them, which is great. Okay. Then I'm sitting down, pushing my knees to the sides and stretching my thighs. The inside. Let's do the other one. Stretch. yoga exercises. Okay, what about if we put our hands up? There we go. Okay. As much as possible. It's a kind of problem, you know. It's copyrighted anyway, so by somebody else. The other way around, please. On your straight, what we're doing, we're turning, doing the circles on our straight knees, right? Okay, it feels like we've got fairly good attention. We gave fairly good attention to our legs. Just getting a little stretch to my thigh. Yeah. If you're doing it with me, make sure you push your pelvis all the way to the front. Okay, kind of curl it up like this. Okay, and then you get a nice stretch on the legs muscles. Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. I would like to move on to the upper part of the body and do some circles in the chest. Everybody does it. All choreographers do it, all dancers do it, so let's do it. The other way around, please. Shoulders two, okay. Together with the chest. Other way around, please. Okay, great. Hands. Start with stretching. Okay. Now we've got a little key that will help to stretch your upper chest. The key is to give a little strain to work with your back muscles. Okay, okay, like this. Then your front gets freed up. In Russian, I would say набрячь. Okay, give some work, make them work. Like you do a workout for abdomen muscles, the same thing. Okay, you give some exercise to your back muscles first, and then you can stretch all you want. Same thing, working with my back muscles, but I'm controlling where my pelvis goes. I gotta push it to the front all the way, okay? And then carefully opening my arms, trying to concentrate on my back muscles. One more time, please. Very much flamenco, okay? Slowly opening up the arms. Okay, my point about the dancing is you have to like it, okay? You have to get kick out of it. And there's an emotional aspect when it feels like a fiesta, like a holiday, okay? Like a party all the time. And there's another aspect, the body aspect, when you really feel good because you're moving, okay? Because you feel every bit of your body. You feel your shoulders, you feel your back, you feel everything. And that's my favorite part, okay? And this is what I'm teaching most of the time, together with the warm-ups, with the choreography, with the techniques and other things, okay? So, let's get back to our shoulders. Going backward. And then let's do two slow with much intention. And then one is pa. Oh, no, the other way. You go pa, pa. And then one slow. Fast. Fast, slow, fast, fast, slow, fast, fast, slow. The same thing to the front. Fast, fast, slow, fast, slow, fast, fast, slow, fast, slow. Okay, one by one, going back. What? And going forward. Backward. And forward. Okay, and it's high time we paid some attention to our neck. Okay. So I would like you again, be careful with it please, okay? But I would like you to feel eventually, okay? As a result of this warm-up, a greater feeling of freedom, okay, in your joints, in your muscles, especially in your neck, okay, especially in the place where it connects to your shoulders, okay. So what we're doing is we're kind of swaying our head gently to the sides without giving it much tension, okay. Just going one way or the other, as if you're a wind, you're feeling the wind. It just feels so good, you just put your face to the wind, okay? Okay, and then carefully going forward, semicircles. I wonder what somebody's messaging me. But not here, not here, not here. Hi guys. Let's go on. And then on your back, same feeling, easy, easy, just easy. Kind of sweat. Then going full circle, one, full circle, two, one more, three, and then full circle to the other way, to the other side. Circle, full circle. All right. Okay, I got an idea. Stay with me. Don't go anywhere. I got an idea of what I would like to listen to right now. And that shall be that should be a song by Sonny Kete, which is a Luz en los Balcones. You should know it, maybe. You may know it, okay? If you're a fan of flamenco, then you know it pretty well. Okay, let me search for it. Hi, I'm still here. Don't go anywhere. I'm searching for the song. Oh, there we go. Colleagues, nice to see you guys. We have a warm-up flamenco style, easy and very lazy style today. Lazy style. So we're going to loosen those balcones, okay? Okay. How are you doing? Okay, feels great. Do shoulders a little more. We are kind of going back and forth on our body to make sure that we warm it up evenly, okay? And have it in a nice working condition. Okay. All right, and it's high time we moved to the wrists, okay? You have to be beautiful, okay? Please be beautiful. Make yourself very pretty. My elbows are sticking to the sides. It's okay. It's normal for flamenco, okay? So if you'd like some flamenco style, stick your elbows out outward. Like this. Okay. This is always the favorite part. Alright, then let's join our wrist movements and our arm movements. Going up, keeping your elbows pointing to the back. Going down. Being pretty. Circle. 2 seconds. Stop. 2 seconds. 1, 2, stop. Ole, up. Circle. Stop. Up. Circle. Stop. Up. 2 circles. Jump. Jump. Stop. Up. 2 circles. Ole. Again. Circle. Marcar. Circle. Marcar. 2 circles. 1, 2. Marcar. E. 1, 2. Marcar. Last time, okay? 1. Marcaje. E. 1. Marcar. 1, 2. Marcaje. 1, 2. Marcar. There we go. Ole. Stretch. 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 Stretch all you can. All the way. Remember about our back and our pelvis going forward. Okay. Very nice. Very nice. Hi guys. Nice to see you. Hello. How are you doing? Okay. Whew. It feels quite warm in here. And how are you? Okay, so what I've prepared for you today is some abanico movements, okay? Abanico is a fan in Spanish. So, woo, I've got two, and I need to decide which one to work with. This one, or... Okay, my left can't do that very easily, so, and this one. I'm not sure which one looks better. Last time I asked you guys and you gave me some wonderful advice. So, which one this time? This one? Tell me yes or no, or this one? Number one or number two? Hey, Elena, hello. So, tell me, number one or number two? Cheek. Ooh. This got flowers on it. This doesn't, but it's got a little more, a tender color, I think. None of them match. None of them match the flowers on my skirt, though, which is pretty bad. I need to work at this, but after, you know, all this stuff finishes. Okay, if you got any ideas, tell me. So far, I'll do them in turns, okay? So, what I would like to suggest we do is we take the abanico, the right hand. I can't really work with the abanico, the left hand. So, right hand, and we do 8. With this point, we go down and up, kind of down, circle, up, circle, down, circle, up, circle, down, circle, up, circle, down, circle, up, circle, okay? And this way, abanico looks like a butterfly. Like a wing of the butterfly, or maybe a hummingbird. You know, when the hummingbird flies, it goes like this. Yeah, it does the... So, this is the way the fan works. Okay. Oh, it's hot. Okay, anyway. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we can go fast. And we can go slow. Bam, bam. So, we're gonna go slow. And our legs are going, we're going to move to the side, a little bit crab style. Pa, I, pa. I'm using my hips, of course, lots of it. Pa, pa. And then I'm using abanico at the same time. So, 1 and 2. Okay? abanico. Let's see what we're gonna do. Everybody, if we don't have abanico, we go ba, ba. Okay, that works just as well. Ba, ba, or maybe one. Ba, ba. You're pretending your hand is something interesting. Okay. Or maybe you have an abanico. I've got another one. Ba. Okay, one more. Moving all the time to one side. Ba. Moving to my left. Ba. 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 All right. How we should move to the left? What do you say? We need to move to the left as well. Okay, so we go la, 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 and we can go to same way, same step in my legs, and I still work with my right hand because I can't work with my left hand with a abanico. Okay, this is I never practiced it. Nobody never got this idea to work with a abanico with the left hand. So I understand the way you feel, okay? You guys, if you have never tried to do it, it's just like, you know, taking a spoon into your left hand and trying to. So anyway, working with my right hand, moving to the right. Ba, ba, still possible, okay? Ba. So moving to the left. One and two and three and four and five and six and one and two and three and four and five and six. Very beautiful. Just keep going. Just keep doing this all the time. That's a beautiful dance, okay? All right, but anyway, I have to continue. I'd like to continue, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm going two of this, one and two, and then I'm going to do a turn, and my hand with abanico, which was like this, the main position is like this, okay? I'm showing the beauty of my fan to my audience, beloved audience, okay? And then I'm kind of turning it towards myself, going with my elbow up, turning it again, and going around my head, okay? So I go one, fix it, like stop, go around, and go one, and go around, then one, and go around. You can add the chest move, you can add whatever you want. Up and around and back and around and back and around. Whoa. And one more. Up and around. Okay, what happened? My fan started to close, and it's not such a good thing, okay? So if you dance with a abanico and you dance flamenco, it is preferable that your abanico is open all the way, or you play with it, okay? You open and close it, or maybe you do it like this, but you do it on purpose, okay? So this is like a ba, ba. Then you have to open. If it's open, it needs to be open all the way, okay? So it is considered not so nice if it's a bit closed, okay? A bit closed doesn't work, okay? So when you work with it, you need to make sure you're holding it in such a way that you don't close it with your arm, okay? I'm showing it close. So I'm holding it here, right here. I'm using my fingers to always control the way it is open, okay? And when I go back to the back, okay, I still control it. I still make sure it is okay. Now I'm turning, not the abanico. I'm turning behind the abanico. Okay, this is fun. You should try it. So anyway, go. Pa, I, pa, I, pa, I, pa. One more. O, pa. Go around. Pa. Go around. Okay, I'll take the other one because I think if you get more contrast and looks, you can see it better, okay? So, one, I, go around. One, I, go around. Now, let's add a turn. Everybody who starts dancing flamenco with me, and always ask me, how do I do this turn? Don't think, okay? So my advice is don't think. Did I just say that? Okay, anyway, cross your legs and then tell your body, come back to the front, like this, okay? So what you do is you straighten your legs, turn around, and come back, and your legs are crossed the other way, okay? Everybody can do it. Everybody. Absolutely everybody. So, just no nerves, no rush, wooding your leg, crossing your leg first, then kind of try and straighten them, and then curl them one more time, going in the circle, okay? And keep your beautiful face to your beloved audience. Oh, hello. Hello. Okay, you can't miss you will be missing your audience, okay? You can't turn away from your audience for a long time, so you have to keep them, watch them. Oh, hi. Okay, all right. So, fun turn, all right? Nice and easy. If you do like this, no, let me show you. For example, like this, and then sometimes you come back too crossed, with your legs too crossed, but that's because you're keeping them too strong on the ground. Take it easy, okay? When you come out of the turn, it needs you need to stand nice and comfortable, okay? Don't cross your legs, don't force yourself. Don't nail them to the ground, okay? Just easy, let them move so you're comfortable, okay? Okay, so what we're gonna do is pa, and cross my legs, and then together with my abanico movement around my head, I do the turn, pa, and I come back, okay? And I'm gonna do one, and two, and cross my leg, throw my abanico behind my head, come back, and stop. And again, I'm coming with a nice position, showing my fan with all of its beauty, okay? Let's do it. Pa, I, pa. So I go pa, I, pa. Again, pa, I, pa. And then I add a turn as well. Pa, I, pa. Okay, one more. Pa, I, pa. Nice. Do it. One, and two, and pa, I, pa. Okay? So this movement is longer than da, da, pa. It takes as much time as the other two, okay? Pam, pa, pa, pam, pa, I, pa, 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 pa. Okay? And to tell you the truth, this is... Hi, Shama! Hi! Hello! To tell you the truth, this movement works... Oh, well, it's composed for a 12-beat compass, okay? Guajira, Okay, that's most typical thing you dance with a pair. Most typical thing. Guajira, and it's a 12-beat compass. Do, un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Y do, un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Okay. Now, hi guys, who knows the compás? Now you can recognize the movements, you know. Those who do not know, it's a 12-beat compás. It's a base for flamenco. And to my point of view, and maybe not only my point of view, the 12-beat compás is most characteristic for flamenco in general. Well, it carries the flamenco vibe the best way. There's also a 4-beat tangos, but that's already, you know, like more semi-Arab, European music. And if you go authentic, closer to Gypsy India, ancient, well, okay, ancient is not a very good word, but anyway, Gypsy Indian flamenco, then a 12-beat compass is closer to that. Or maybe sometimes you go with 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, but 12-beat compass encloses the 3-beat inside, of course, because you can count 1, 2, 3, pa 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 pa, 4 times. Okay. So that's a little bit of theory. Now we go. 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, with a se, I get prepared, se, that's when I finish preparation, and my my hand is behind my head already, se, siete, ocho, nueve, diez, and we count in English, it's going to be difficult, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. E. 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's difficult for me to count in English, not native, so I'll continue counting in Spanish. Anyway, let's do it. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez, un, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Very nice. What about moving to the other side? Let's try and do it. Do, un, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. Now we can. Yeah, we can. Seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Y, do, un, dos. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The turn looks different, okay? You go that way, okay? You put your arm in front of your face, behind your head, and so on. And the other way, you go pa first, like this. Let me think. As if you're looking at something here, and then you continue to look at this side, but turn your head to your beloved audience, of course. You go like this, okay? The other way around. Pa. So you can see we can do it both ways. So let's do one way, other way. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez, y do, un, do, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Y do, un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Very good. Then go. Do, un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Just one time. Okay? Why? Because I've got something else for you. I've got another, a bit more complicated schema. Let's do it like this. It's going to be do, uno, do, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Okay, nueve, diez, y un do. So, you have to, no, excuse me, please. I wanted to do it with an abanico. Pa, 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 pa. And then maybe close, maybe not. It doesn't matter. Again. First, your abanico is looking at you, and you're at him. And then you're not looking at him anymore. Boom. Okay? Then, you turn it. You point it outward. And then, you try to close the circle with your hand, like this. Okay? Like this. But, you do not touch. Do not touch your abanico. Like this. As if you would like to draw a circle. A full circle that will enclose your arm and your other arm and your abanico. Okay? But this circle is too large. So you can't really close it. Okay? So you keep it open a little bit. Pa, 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 pa. Okay. And how you do this? How do you do this trick? A very beautiful, nice, lovely lady who is part of Bravate team, living in Peru, gave this analogy, who is a teacher of flamenco and a dancer of flamenco, of course, gave this analogy for these turns. Imagine there is a line. There is a line that starts with you, then goes on the floor, to the sides, on the ceiling, to the other wall, and then comes back to you, okay? So this line is you. I mean, it's the line on your stand on. And when you turn, you try to move your arms along this imaginary line, okay? The same. Well, I don't know, yeah, I think you can go both ways, actually. But imaginary line, keep it. Cheek, it's over here, on the ceiling, it's over there on the wall, it's over here, on the floor. Poo, 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 no more. Ching, chick, 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 chick. Okay. That's how we're gonna use the turn. That's how we're gonna. Pa, and pa. You have to finish, right? Seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez, un, do. And I also think we will start the turn on a six. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Okay. And that's, it's going to be a finishing compás in our whole composition. Now we need four compasses. Why? Why do we need four compasses? If you take guajira, I think it would be quite typical to have a guitar phrase consisting of four compasses, okay? And that's why we do this little set of exercise, a little set of movements in four, so you can use it, okay? Of course you can cut it and throw away stuff and use it for just three of them or one of them or whatever, or not use it at all. But I would like to do it a set of four. So I'm inside the imaginary guitar phrase. Or maybe you can listen to some later. Okay? So we go. One, do, oh, perdón. Do. Do, un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Y un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2. Okay, so we go 2 to the right, 1 to the left, then pa, you go 2, Un, dos, tres, cuatro. Okay? I'm just pointing to the right, to the left, and opening abanico on the up. Again, I'm starting to lose my English, whatever. Please, just follow along. Mm-hmm. Do, do, uno, do, tre, cuatro. Mm-hmm. And for those who know compás, we are changing accents, okay? First we go with the typical accents. Uno, un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Do, un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Again, typical. Un, do, tre, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. And then go, do, uno, do, tre, cuatro. In music, we're not going to have that. We're not going to have those accents, but that's the beauty of it. That's, in Russian, it says polyphonia, polyrhythmia, polyrhythmic, okay? That's you do the polyrhythm. That's a typical of flamenco, very cool thing. Okay, so you go un, do, uno, do, tre, cuatro, and then se, of course you do it. Se, siete, ocho, nueve, diez, un, do. Okay. I think we need to try it with guajira compás. Still here. I suggest we do it a couple of times with compass, compass, and kind of finish up. Okay. Guajira media con guitarra, guajira rápida, guajira lenta. Let's see this one. That's not very. That's not very slow. The music, right? And the music got its structure, okay? And when I'm doing just exercises, I'm not thinking about the music, about the structure of some specific music. I'm just enjoying myself, doing techniques, doing the turns and stuff. So this means the whole combination, 2, 3, 4, may not fit into this particular music, okay? But if you have a good ear, you tend to follow the music, right? And you may want to slow down and maybe do the turn slower. Two compasses, instead of one, two compasses, and then finish up together with the phrase, the musical phrase you are hearing. So let's try it one more time. What I did was right, turn. Right, turn, left, turn, stop, pam, pam, remate, y slow turn. Then, to give me some variety, I started moving to the right. Right, turn, then left, turn. And then we came to a point where the musical phrase did not finish with this compass. It had two more compasses. So we do remate, pam, pam, pam. Cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez, uno, dos, one more. We make it longer. No. Tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Okay, so we do the last turn. a second turn, two times as long. Do two compasses instead of one. Now we can repeat and see if it works, okay? So, I don't know if I start at the very beginning. No, left. So, un, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. Faccio nel piede. Okay, try not to make it too difficult. So, we start with the very start of the music. So, if you, like myself, I was standing and listening, shall I start or not, shall I start or not? And I was standing for one whole compass. So, instead of two moving to the side, I just did one. Do, un, do, tre, quattro, cinque, sei, sette, ocho, then to your right. Do, un, do, tre. Because I was standing the first compass, so we kind of leave it out. Let's do it again. Wait, wait, one compass to the right, one compass to the left. Rimane. Do, uno, do, tre, quattro. Long turn, sei, siete, ocho, nove, diez. Then long phrase, long guitar phrase. To the right, one compass. To the right, second compass. To the right, to the left, one compass, pa. And then rimate, pa, 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 pa. And turn for two compasses. Sei, siete, ocho, nove, diez, un, do, tre, quattro, cinco, sei. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Okay. Wow. Okay, I figured out my I figured out the source of the sound. So let's do it one more time. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez. My time was out on the Instagram. That's nice. Ah. So that was about an hour. Let's do it one last time with you, and then we'll finish up. And I will post my live on the Instagram so the guys can watch it later. And that's it. So, one more time, please, with guitar. Sette, ocho, nove, dieci, do, fa. Thank you very much for watching. Come again with your abanicos so we can continue dancing. All right, so here's a kiss.